In the past year, so many things have changed across different platforms for content creators of all styles and all talents. And Discord is most certainly no exception. They released the mega upgrade to slash commands, templates for setting up servers, complete integration of threads. They gave us custom stickers. They sent Wampus into space.
They did what? Why would they do that?
They gave us server timeouts, auto mod upgrades, text chat and voice, server forums, app directory, and we finally figured out how to pronounce
Discord.
But we're not here to simply revel in what Discord has done over the past year. We're here to set up a Discord community, and we want to make it look great and feel safe. So roll intro and let's get started. If you haven't already grabbed Discord and created yourself an account, go and get that set up. You can simply grab Discord from discord.com and you can run it from the website if you want, but I prefer the desktop version myself, so we're going to be using that for today's setup. So once you're logged into Discord, you're going to have something that looks like this. Now maybe you've already had experience with Discord, so this might be a wee bit more full, but if not and it's brand new, all you got to do is come up to this plus sign up here that says add a server. Click on that and we can get started with creating the basics of our server. There are templates that you can use and I absolutely would recommend checking these out and just testing this, because at the start it's just going to be you on the server, so have a look around, see what the templates offer, but for now I'm just going to create a blank server using the create my own button right here. Now you can set these up for study groups and all sorts of things, or just you and your friends. I'm setting this up to be a community, so we click on that one right there, and this is optional at this point. You can come back and do this, but you can name the server here and change the image as well. You can always come back and change the image and the name of the server as many times as you want, so don't feel it has to be set in stone at this point. Once you hit create, that's your server now in the Discord universe. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is come up to the title, click on that and go to server settings. Now in the overview section, as I said before, you can change the logo of the server, change the name, and there's a whole bunch of other things you can do in here as well, but don't worry about that for now. What we want to do is go into the community section, so come down here and click on enable community. Once in here, click on get started, and there's a few things that a community needs to basically be kept safe. So the first one is people need to have a verified email on their account before they're allowed to join your server. The next section is an explicit media content filter. Simply agree to that and hit next. Now it's going to ask if you want to make a rule or guidelines channel, and it will make one for you, which is pretty cool. The second section is a community updates channel, and this is where Discord's basically going to tell you and your mods what is coming up in terms of changes and server adjustments to Discord in general. So I'm happy for this to create a channel for both of these. I'm going to hit next. Some last settings that Discord will set up for you. One being that the default settings will be mentions only, so that you can't get spammed with someone who's coming in and say going live at here or at everyone. We've all had that. We've all had a notification go off and realize that we're not really being talked to. It's pretty frustrating. It disables that kind of stuff, which I think is a no-brainer. You can adjust this stuff as you add in new roles like moderators and admins and such, but for now, this looks good to me. I'm going to agree and I'm going to hit finish setup. Well, that's a community server set up, but it's just the foundations. We want to set up a welcome screen as well as putting a rule screening section in to make sure people know what the server's about and what we won't tolerate. Such as saying anything bad about Henry Cavill's Witcher. Why did he have to leave? He didn't even get the Superman job. So click on the welcome screen button and right away it's going to show you what a welcome screen would look like once it's set up. Looks pretty nice. Click on the welcome screen button again. In here we're going to select, well, the only channel that we have at the minute, which is general, and we're just going to say what it's about. So people talking about general stuff, and it lets you pick an emoji which you can set for each server you put on your welcome screen. What's great is you can add in more channels, you can put in descriptions for each channel, and you can move them into different orders as well. You can put in a little blurb here about what your server is about, and you can click the preview button, and it's even going to show you what this looks like whenever someone joins. I like that, so I'm going to just leave it as it is and hit enable. Now that your welcome screen is up and running, we're going to have a little look at the auto mod and safety setup just to make sure that this place is airtight, okay? Nobody's coming in talking about Henry Cavill.
Stop it. get some help.
So on the auto mod page, you're going to have a few sections here. We're just going to go from top to bottom. The top one here is block mention spam. What block mention spam does is it limits the number of unique mentions of a particular role and user per message. So here you can see it says unique mentions, role and user per message. Limit the number of unique mentions in each message. And this is set to 20. You can bring this right down, you can put it up. It really depends what you prefer. Once you configure the rule limits, you can come down to the response. So if somebody, for example, went beyond the limit that we've just set for unique mentions per message, we can choose to block the message. You can also have an alert sent to whatever channel you want. So if I wanted the moderators to be alerted to someone maybe breaking the rules of the mention spam, it could send a message to them, and I could actually not even block the message and let them decide manually if they want to take it away or not. You can have more aggressive responses as well, where you can time out a member for a set amount of time, with the minimum being 60 seconds and the maximum being 1 week. As well as that, there are exceptions to the rules, so you can make sure moderators don't get caught up in this rule, and you can just, you know, play favorites and really polarize the community by just picking the odd person that just gets away with everything, you know? Give them something to talk about, even if that is how much they hate you. The next rule we have here is the block suspected spam content. And if you come in here, it basically outlines what the rule does. If the message is suspected of being spam, you have a response to choose from block message, send alert, or both. Again, you have exceptions to this rule, but it says down here that admin and managed server permissions are always excluded from the filter rules. So bear that in mind. The next section is block commonly flagged words. This is pretty good because it already gives you a big database of words that it would think are worth flagging. Things that are just no-brainers that you would want to put in here anyway. There's a handful of language types here that it'll let you switch on, and it will actually let you omit words as well. So if the auto mod catches a word that is not, in your opinion, a bad word to have on the server, you can stick it in here. You can put in words or phrases and you just separate them by commas. Again, we've got the choose response section. You can choose either or both, and the omission section as well for green lighting certain people to just be absolute hellions. You know the one. Finally, we have the block custom word section. It's kind of based off what the commonly flagged words is, only this is going to let you choose particular things that maybe Discord doesn't have in its database of words that it would usually flag. It has a rejects pattern section for advanced matching, so you know there'll be some people who will try and write a bad word using all types of combinations of letters and symbols. They're not going to get away with it. You just set it up in here and you got them. Boom.
Done.
The next bit is allowing words to be brought back in, omitted if you don't think they're actually bad words. Again, at the bottom, we have the responses that you might want to choose. You can use all three or any combination of the three. It's really up to you. And of course, you have the omission of rules at the bottom yet again. I think one really good way of using the block custom words rule is if, say, there's a show or a game that you're playing or watching and it's got a great story, you're really loving it, and you just don't want anyone to come in and start spoiling the story before you've got past that section, you could just start blocking sections outright. Obviously, there are rules that kind of stop that kind of stuff, but if someone just doesn't see that or they just don't care, you can stop them by putting in keywords here and just make sure they don't accidentally or purposely spoil it for other people. The next section we're going to look at is rule screening. This is just a handful of rules that's going to pop up before anyone can get onto your server, and they have to agree to those rules before they can participate in your community. So click on the setup membership screening button and you're going to find that the verification level is in here. This is basically to say how much verification an account needs. So it starts at the basic low level of just needing a verified email to get onto the server, and you can change this to all sorts of options like needing to be registered on Discord for longer than 5 or 10 minutes, or also having a verified phone linked to the Discord account. It's really up to you. Just make sure that people aren't mass creating accounts and just dropping in and causing havoc. You can describe what your server is about right here. Then down here, you can set up the server rules just by clicking on Get Started. Something cool that Discord does is it gives you template rules, and they're all rules that you probably want people to follow. Be civil and respectful, no spam or self-promo, no obscene content, and help keep the server safe for everybody there. You can add a few more if you want, but really try and keep this to a small number of rules, because if this turns into a full-on book for people to read, they're going to lose interest. So keep it in around these character counts, and you're going to have easy bite-sized rules for people to read through. Once you're done, click on save and you can preview those rules right here. Once you're happy with that, click away and just hit enable, and that's it. You've got the rules set up for your server. Nice one. Just a couple of more things to show you. One being the integrations and app directory sections on their apps. Integrations just lets you connect your Twitch or your YouTube or both accounts to the server itself, which is really handy for people who are maybe subscribed to you on Twitch or are a member of your YouTube channel. It'll synchronize their subscription or their membership over into your Discord channel and let them use the emotes that they've gained by supporting your channel directly in your Discord. It's a nice little touch, I think. The next section is the app directory. And this place, you could get lost in here for a very long time. But one thing that I really would recommend checking out is the moderation and tools section. There's lots of stuff in here. I'm not going to go into mega detail on it, but you can get other bots that can do crazy good things for your server. I'd recommend checking out the websites of these bots, hitting YouTube up, and just researching a bit on what kind of bot you would want for your server. One last thing that I'm going to mention, and it's only because in the previous video we did, this was like a brand new thing and we had to enable it. Now it's just part of it. When you click on the plus button in your chat, you can go and you can create a thread. Threads are great if you have a conversation that you want to have with somebody in the chat, but not take over the chat entirely. You guys can kind of move to the side and have your own discussion without it interfering with anybody else. You can even set it up where you invite the particular people in that you want to have the thread with. It's really, really great stuff, and it's good for so many different reasons. Other things like support channels, where maybe someone's having a bit of trouble with OBS, and you can split them off in the threads so that they're not all getting in the way of each other and different conversations are getting totally lost in a sea of text. And that's it. That's your community server set up. Let me know what you thought in the comments, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.